Okay, we're reading today from Srimad Bhagavad Gita as it is, translation and purport by Divine Grace. It's kind of found by Charya, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Prabhupada. 15, 15, 19. This is chapter 15. This is the yoga of the Supreme Person. Yamam evam samudho.
Yamam evam samudho.
Janati purushottamam.
Janati purushottamam.
Sarvasarvid bhajati mam.
Sarvasarvid bhajati mam.
Sarvabhavena bharata.
Sarvabhavena bharata.
Yo, Janati Puruto Tamam.
Janati Puruto Tamam.
Sasava Vibhajanti Man.
Sasava Vibhajanti Man.
Sarvaba Enabharata.
Sasava Enabharata.
Whoever knows me, this is Krishna speaking. Whoever knows me as the Supreme Personality of Godhead without doubting is the knower of everything. He therefore engages himself in full devotional service to me, O son of Bharata.
译文，Krishna这么说：Bharata的儿子啊，谁确切的知道我是至尊人格首持人，谁就是一切的知悉者，因此全心全意的为我做奉爱服务。
Purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. There are many philosophical speculations about the constitutional position of the living entities and the Supreme Absolute Truth. Now, in this verse, the Supreme Personality of Godhead clearly explains that anyone who knows Lord Krishna to be the Supreme Person is actually the knower of everything. The imperfect knower goes on simply speculating about the Absolute Truth, but the perfect knower, without wasting his valuable time, engages directly in Krishna consciousness, the devotional service of the Supreme Lord. Throughout the whole of Bhagavad Gita, this fact is being stressed at every step. And still, there are so many stubborn counterfeiters on Bhagavad Gita who consider the Supreme Absolute Truth and the living entities to be one and the same. Vedic knowledge is called Shruti, learning by oral reception. One should actually receive the Vedic message from authorities like Krishna and his representatives. Here, Krishna distinguishes everything very nicely, and one should hear from this source. Simply to hear like the hogs is not sufficient. One must be able to understand from the authorities. It is not that one should simply speculate academically. One should submissively hear from Bhagavad Gita that these living entities are always subordinate to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Anyone who is able to understand this, according to the Vedas, Sri Krishna knows the purpose of the Vedas. No one else knows the purpose of the Vedas. The word bhajati is very significant. In many places, the word bhajati is expressed in relationship with the service of the Supreme Lord. If a person is engaged in full Krishna consciousness, If a person is engaged in full Krishna consciousness and devotional service of the Lord, it is to be understood that he has understood all of the Vedic knowledge. In the Vaishnava Parampara, it is said that if one is engaged in the devotional service of Krishna, then there is no need for any other spiritual process for understanding the Supreme Absolute Truth. He has already come to the point because he is engaged in the devotional service of the Lord. He has ended all preliminary processes of understanding. But if anyone, after speculating for hundreds of thousands of lives, does not come to the point that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and that one has to surrender there, all his speculation for so many years and lives is a useless waste of time.
要是关于生物和至尊绝对真理的原本地位，有许多哲学的思辨家。现在至尊人格守神在这节诗中清楚地解释说，谁知道主 Krishna 是至尊人，谁就是真正知道一切的人。不完美的知悉者只是在猜测什么是绝对真理，但完美的知悉者却直接从事与 Krishna 意识有关的活动，为至尊主做奉爱服务，不浪费他宝贵的时间。整个佛前梵歌至始至终都在一步一步地强调这个事实，但仍有许多顽固的评注 Bhagavad Gita 的人认为至尊绝对真理与生物是一样的，是同一个个体。 Veda 知识称为 Shruti， 是通过聆听来学习的，事实上应该从像 Krishna 和他的代表这样的权威那里接受伟达知识。 Krishna 在这里把一切都分析得清清楚楚，所以应该听从来自于这个源头的话，仅仅像猪一样的听是不行的，人必须能理解从权威那里聆听到的知识。这不是说应该只进行学术思辨，而是说应该顺从的聆听 Bhagavad Gita 的知识，就是生物永远从属于至尊人格守神。至尊人格守神 Sri Krishna 的说法是，谁能理解这一点的人知道 Veda 经的目的，其他人则不知道 Veda 经的目的。Bhajati 一词很有意思， Bhajati 在很多地方都表示与为主做的奉爱服务有关。如果一个人满怀 Krishna 意识为主做奉爱服务，那么就应该明白他已经了解了所有的 Veda 知识。 Vaishnava Parampara 中所说，如果一个人为 Krishna 做奉爱服务，那他就不需要为了了解绝对真理而按其他灵性方法修炼了。他已经了解了绝对真理，因为他为主做奉爱服务，他已经练完了一切帮助人了解绝对真理的初级方法。但是如果一个人在思辨了成千上万事后，仍没有认识到 Krishna 是至尊人的守神，应该皈依他，那么他生生世世进行的思辨就是无用的，再浪费时间。
Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gnanjana Silakaya Chakshurum Militam Jena Tasmaya Si Gurube Namaha Si Chetatanya Purushisam Stapitam Jena Bhutale Svayarupa Tadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vande Om Si Guru Si Juta Parakamanam Si Guru Vaishnavascha Shri Rupam Sakrachatam Sahagana Raghunatam Pitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Sapadutam Parishana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakam Vitam Shcha Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Manu Jagatpate GopiNath And education, what is of the highest education? Actually, these temples, Srila Prabhupada told us that our temples and centers in ISKCON are meant for spiritual education.
所以什么叫做灵性教育？那包括说我们的庙宇啦，我们的聚会中心啊，是要做灵性教育的地方。
That means preaching, teaching, studying.
那就是要做 研读经典啊，阅读研读还要去传教。
Because this education, this spiritual education of this Bhagavad science is lacking in modern man, modern education.
因为呢，在现代人还有现代的教育里面，是缺乏了这种对主巴格万的这个知识。
Everyone is more or less taught from kindergarten. They're more or less brainwashed by modern science if they went to school at all.
基本上呢，每个人在这个世界几乎都是从开始从幼稚园开始上学的时候都已经所谓一直上学教导都是所谓现代的知识或现代的这种概念。
But there's actually a verse I'm going to jump to quickly since you have Bhagavad Gita. It's a wonderful verse, 1870, where Krishna puts it perfectly in a nutshell.
所以呢，有一节诗特别的是 Krishna 觉得也是一个很重要的重点，第十八章第七十节。
He says to Arjuna, and I declare that he who studies this sacred conversation of ours.Worships me by his intelligence.
Krishna 就说了，研习就是 Krishna 跟 Arjuna 这些神圣对话的人，是以他的智力来崇拜着 Krishna 的。
Worships me by his intelligence. That's what we're doing.
那就是说，以智力、智慧来崇拜 Krishna 呢，是我们正在做的事。
And earlier in Bhagavad Gita, of course, there are 18 chapters, but in earlier chapters, Krishna described other processes of yoga, other types of yoga, for the benefit. It appears like he was testing his friend and giving him a choice, but actually it was for the benefit of other people in the future who will hear this Bhagavad Gita.
那在先前的章节里面的因为整部《国切梵歌》有十八章，前面的很多内容呢，看起来是好像 Krishna 在考验他的朋友啊，对他 Arjuna 的这个考验，在测试他。但事实上 ，Krishna 对 Arjuna 这些对话跟教导呢，是对后代人的益处而提出的。
All through the Bhagavad Gita, whenever Krishna speaks about himself to his good and dear friend Arjuna, he says, "Me, mom."
在这整部《国切梵歌》里面呢 ，Krishna 对 Arjuna 的说话的时候 ，Krishna 是以他自己我来称呼的。
And he described actually the topmost yoga after Karma Kanda and Karma Yoga.Not karma, karma yoga, jnana yoga, and astanga yoga. That's with various siddhis, mystic powers.
So Krishna 就描述了瑜伽的各个部分，从最开始的活动业报瑜伽功力活动，再来呢就是知识思辨瑜伽，然后再来一层一层的往到奉爱瑜伽。
Do you understand what karma kanda means?
要知道什么叫 karma kanda 的意思。
Does everybody know karma yoga?
大家知道 Karma Yoga 又是怎么说的
？In the Karma Kanda section of the Vedas, Karma Yoga.
在这个韦陀经的 Karma Kanda 这个部分，就是里面讲述的是 Karma Yoga.
It means to worship a deity, to attain something material, to get a material benediction.
就是在崇拜某一个神像。然后这个目的是为了得到物质上的回报，物质上的利益。
That means a new, a better job, a raise, a husband, a son, a new car, pass the test, like that.
还有就是人们去这样去崇拜，是为了想要说有一个好的丈夫啦，好的儿子啦，好的工作啦，好的汽车啦，好的财富这些东西。
And if people do not hear from proper authority, then they can become very confused when it comes to the point, the fact that there are millions and millions of demigods, devatas.
如果人们没有正确的从正确的源头去聆听知识呢，在他做了很多事情之后，后来呢才晓得无所适从，因为有数百万的半神人啊神仙。
And therefore, you can see how many branched this tree is looking, you know, in the pursuit of knowledge and understanding of what is truth and what is real. There are many, many infinite branches in this goal of pursuing truth and knowledge.
所以呢，在追寻真理的这条路上呢，就有很多的分歧。太多太多的这种枝枝节的小细节的这种知识，就像一棵树呢，有很多枝枝节节的东西。
Actually, then later Krishna tells Arjuna, he says, this is in 6:47. He tells him. 6:47.
第六章第四十七节 ，Krishna 对 Arjuna 说了。
This is Krishna telling Arjuna. Of course, Vyasadeva could hear, and it was being recorded also. But what is this small Bhagavad Gita? It's getting harder to read. Yoginam abhisarvesham madgaten ataratmana sadhavan bhajate yomam samayuktatmomata. Anyway, and of all the yogis, the one with great faith who always abides in me, thinks of me within himself, and renders transcendental loving service to me, he is the most intimately united with me in yoga and is the highest of all. That is my opinion. That's Krishna telling his dear friend.
在所有的瑜伽师中，谁信仰坚定的，总在内心想着我，为我做超然的爱心服务，谁就是通过瑜伽与我最紧密的连接在一起，也就是最高级的瑜伽师。那这是我的看法，这是 Krishna 自己说的。
So that was after explaining to Arjuna different kinds of yoga, then he told him this bhakti yoga, this is the highest.
所以呢，菩萨对阿朱那说了很多种瑜伽之后，告诉他呢，这是最高的瑜伽，就是对菩萨的奉爱服务。
And then another one, 9:2. I'm jumping to the new book.
第九章第二节。
Rajavijja, Rajavijja, Rajaguhyam, Abhitam.Rajavijja Rajaguhyam Abhitam Idam Bhutamam Pratyaksavgadam Dhamyam Sisukam Kartam Avyayam. This knowledge is the king of education, the most secret of all secrets. It is the purest knowledge, and because it gives direct perception of the self by realization, it is the perfection of religion, it is everlasting, and it is joyfully performed.
这一节的译文是这样，这门知识是教育之王，是最机密的机密，最纯粹的知识，因为它使人直接觉悟到自我，所以是完美的宗教，它是永恒的，实践起来令人快乐。
So, this is the king of knowledge, because Arjuna was kingly, and also because it is the topmost knowledge.
这门知识是教育之王。然后呢，阿朱拉是一个王族的人，那这个知识又是最高的、最纯粹的知识。
Okay, see what Srila Prabhupada says in his purport. Throughout the whole of Bhagavad Gita, this fact is being stressed at every step. What fact is he talking about? Just above the sentence.The imperfect knower goes on simply speculating about the absolute truth, but the perfect knower, without wasting his valuable time, engages directly in Krishna consciousness, the devotion service of the Supreme.
所以在这里面呢 ，Krishna 说，帮他就说前面说了那么多是什么呢？就是说呢，很多人在各种知识里面的知解里面去追寻知识，然后做了很多的思辨，那这种呢，仅仅是浪费时间。
In Srila Prabhupada's purport here, he mentioned that the word bhajati is very significant in many places in the Bhagavad Gita. Many places the word.
然后在这里呢 ，Prabhupada 说 bhajati 这个字是非常重要，因为在很多地方呢都有提到。
In many places, the word bhajati is expressed in relationship with the service of the Supreme Lord.
在很多地方呢 ，bhajati 这个字呢是提到呢关于跟主对主的服务有关的关系。
Also, bhakti, bhajati, they're related.
所以 bhakti 跟 bhajati 呢是相关联的。
There's actually one verse in the Bhagavad Gita later on. 1855, Bhaktiya Mama Vijanati, Yavanyas Chaspitaputa, that I am approached only by Bhakti.
那在第十八章五十八节里面 ，Krishna 又说了呢，只有奉爱才可以被，就是才可以接近他。
Love and devotion. Prabhupada translates that as love and devotion.
包括翻译成就是爱跟奉献。
With service, love and devotion service.
所以我们是仆人，那我们的服务呢是爱跟奉献的。
So all through the Bhagavad Gita and certainly many other places in the Vedas, it's stated very clearly that it's only by love and devotional service and worship that one can attain God.
所以在整部佛前梵歌里面还有维他经的很多地方都说到只有爱跟奉献这样的服务呢才能得到对主的这样的爱
In the Sri Brahma Samhita 533 there's one